Okay, Vinesh, in this video, we will make it more professional. Like, we will add price range and category, and we will add here button for such particular combination of product. So, for that, I have to change this type of select scenario. So, go to your editor, open resources view, front. And we have a products blade. Here you will see we have a UI li. So I will make it simple. Delete your UI li. This div also I will delete it and make it option. We don't need any class, just delete it. It's just for your optional. Is theme design, we will design it our own. Okay, make it option, and outside we will make it select, and we will set a category ID, like a cat ID. You can use any name of ID we will use under our script. Select delete. That's it. Here your option, you will change it. Select a category, save it, value simple empty. Okay, and ID you will delete here. Okay, because we are have a ID here, and option have two things, class option anything, and yes, name of this, that's it. Okay, now reload, you will see everything is okay, nothing is changed in design. Okay, now open our JS. Here you have changed something. If click here my button will find btn. I will add a new button. Here we will add here. Okay, so I will delete it. Button ID same, find button here. You will say find button, save it. Now you can see you have a here button. I think some design, let me find it. Okay, no problem, you can add here, save it. If someone click here, then we will get category ID. So we have to put here simple, your category ID name is get ID. Copy this, use here. Here you will get category ID value. What is the value? Values category ID. Now you are not using any dynamic data, so you can delete this for each. Save it, reload your page, select any category randomly, click on find. Let me allot some cat. Okay, save it, reload, select any category, click on find. You will get two, and result is here. That is good veggie. Find is 16. Here is your data. So nothing is fancy. I just change the value of your ID. Now you need to add here also. Select price range, simple. Okay, here you will put some data like a 0 to 100 100 to 300 300 to anything you can add here. 500 to 1000, same thing you will add here. 300 to 500, 100 to 300, 0 to 100. Simply, and it's empty. Now change it price. Simple. Someone click on this scenarios drop down. You will see here price. What price? Price will be simple price dot value. I'm not explaining what I'm doing. I'm sure you already know what is this. Here is, we will put one parameter more for price and plus sign price variable. That's it. Now click any category, click any range, open inspect element, find. Okay, we have a spec error here. Okay, I'm sorry. Reload, select any category, select any price range, click on find, and network. You will see what we have a pass in header. Here is price range, here is category ID. Now it's going to our controller. Open app http controller product controller. Here is our data is coming. Okay, I will show you. Let me comment this, and here you will put price variable request. Simple, put price. Select category, price range, click on button, and here is your price range. Change the price range, and here is your new price range. Now you can see we have a two parameters, 100 and 300, 0 and 100. We have to make it separate according to our price range query. So for that, let me show you how we will do. We will do it print R. Explode. This sign will load this price simple. Reload, select category, select price range, and here is your array. Now you will put this for your price variable. Here you will put here hyphen and your price, save it. Now we have something, save it, start price array index 1 echo, and that means price end. Now you will see is separate. Select price range, click on range. Here is 100 and 300, 300 and 500. Here is your data. Now we can make query according to this parameters. Let me remove this alert, and here we will copy this query. But before that, we have to check if get ID not equal to 0 and price variable not equal to 0, then that means user select both of this. Okay, then we will put here one more where condition for price, that is products dot pro price. That will be greater than equal to start. It will be greater than start and where. Now we will make it less than